Mr. Tripathi Rao has secured all-round rank of 441. Actually, in interview, see in prelims, mains interview, you know prelims is just qualifying. He got very good score in prelims, but it's qualifying, so let us not discuss about that. Coming to the mains interview, the marks of mains and interview will be added. And based on the final marks, mains interview, your rank will be decided. In interview, Tripathi Rao has got 193 marks, which is among the top 10 marks in India. So interview-wise, he is among top 10. Coming to the mains, we have essay and general studies 1, 2, 3, 4, and option. In essay and general studies, he has got among the top 100. He has got among the top 100 in India. Interview, he has got among the top 10. But what happened is, in optional, his optional is Telugu literature. His optional is literature. And in that, this year, Telugu literature marks were completely, mellowed down. He has got only 236 marks. Generally, for 236 marks, UPSC rank getting is impossible. Just for 236 marks, generally you cannot get a rank. But because his general studies are very good and his interview is very good, that's why he got rank 441. If he has chosen any other optional, or if in the literature this year, if they have given decent marks, if he has got at least some 270, which is a normal score for most of the students of other optionals, anthropology, sociology, geography, history, public administration, political science, most of them got 270. If he has got that kind of score, an optional, his rank would definitely be in top 50. His rank will be top 50. So this has actually pulled him down. However, because he belongs to OBC category, there are very high chances that he will get IAS for this rank. For general category, for this rank, you will not get IAS. But for OBC, last year, till 470 rank, they have given IAS. So this year also, they're expecting, let us see what happens. Well, friends, Mr. Tripathi Rao, previously also, he gave 3 attempts previously. But at the time, he was working as tribal consultant in government of Andhra Pradesh, tribal consultant. And he has done some mistakes, because of which once he missed in the prelims, once he missed in the mains, once he missed in the interview. This time, as he has come to us, we have identified some common mistakes that along with him, many other aspirants do, some basic mistakes. And we rectified those mistakes. And particularly to improve the communication skill for interview, what we have done is, we have asked him to take few classes in our academy. Along with civil services, as you know, we have degree and intermediate class also. So for different sections, we asked him to take some few classes. Because by taking some classes, by sharing the knowledge, your communication will be improved. And that actually helped him in gaining more marks in interview. Also, some mistakes that he has done earlier have been rectified, because of which he has got good marks in the general studies. But friends, this particular optional is not available in our academy. Theory literature is not there with us. So he prepared by himself, and this year marks were generally less for this option. So this is the overall background of Mr. Tripathi Rao. And coming to the strategy that we are asking to discuss now, I think discussing entire strategy in single class is not possible. It's not possible. Because strategy means, one is the book. What are the various resources that he followed, basic books he referred to, the newspaper he has read, the magazines he has read, that is one thing. Second thing is, what is the strategy he followed for revision, or what is the strategy he followed for mains answer writing? What is the strategy he followed to improve his interview marks? Then, what are the mistakes he has done in the previous attempts, and what are the mistakes that most of the aspirants do? Many people work very hard. They are intelligent, but still they will not get the rank. Why? They will not get the rank because there are some common mistakes most of the aspirants will do. Friends, it's very common, I'm telling you, very common. Because there are many people who prepare smartly. Within 1 year, they'll crack the rank. The reason is not because they're very intelligent. The reason is not because they're highly hardworking. The reason is they do time management very well, and they study smartly. They manage the books very smartly. They revise nicely. They practice Vedanta studying in a very limited time. I mean, it's a combination of all the things. That's why called smart study. Today, among these four, he will focus on anyone. He'll finish it. Maybe in the next section, he'll take one more topic. Like that, three or four times he will discuss the strategy. The reason why I brought Tripathi Rao is that his mains mocks are among the top 100 in India. Interim mocks are among the top 10. So though his rank is 441, according to me, he's a top 50 candidate. Top 50 candidate. Also, the reason why I bring him because he's a person who already wrote three times and he knows what are the mistakes that he has done. What you should not do. That way, he'll be more helpful and his strategy will be very useful for all of you. Friends, without further delay, let me call Tripathi Rao and he will come and say his strategy.
Thank you, sir, for giving me such a nice introduction about me, even though I'm not eligible for that. But anyway, today I'm going to discuss about the smart work that we need to do in civils preparation. Smart work. Yes. Gone are the days where you need to spend 18 to 20 hours for civils preparation. Because at that point there was two options and you need to read a lot of content. But now the civil service exam pattern has been more dynamic and they wanted flexibility from the candidate. Because after getting into civil service, you need to work in diverse conditions, you need to deal with diverse situations and diverse people, diverse problems. So you want that flexibility and analytical skills to deal with such diverse challenges. That's why the pattern has become more flexible. So the present civil service examination tests such skills in the candidates, right? Today I'm going to discuss what is the smart work that we need to do at the various levels: prelims, mains, and interview. Interview also we need smart work. Interview level also. See, one more thing, you remember, civil service preparation starts with interview and ends with interview. That is important point. Why I'm saying that particularly starts with interview and ends with interview? Because civil service, even though we call interview, actually it is personality test. In general parlance, we call it as interview, but it is personality test. That is why civil service talks about interview. Civil service interview starts with interview and ends with interview. That's why I want to highlight this point, emphasize this point, because Sarath sir particularly guided me on all these aspects at various stages. Especially interview, is without his guidance, I would have wouldn't have scored such 193 score. So why I'm saying that personality test starts with, because interview in civil service interview, it is not about knowledge test. It is knowledge test, not about knowledge test like other Viva Voice tests or other interview tests for other examinations. It is about your personality test. Personality. What personality is it about? It's your opinion about it. Particular issue, your stand about a particular issue, your qualities, whether you are able to communicate properly, you are able to take a clarity in thinking, whether you are able to have some skills required to become a civil servant. What are the skills to become a civil servant? Leadership skills. So leadership skills, honesty in expression, honesty, empathy, and whether you can do things efficiently is also efficiency. So you should use the whatever resources available optimally and get the things done. Because you need to have idea about the socioeconomic challenges in a district or in a state if you are a secretary. And you, how will you use these socio-economic resources for the upliftment of socio-economic conditions of the people? This is what civil service is all about, right? So for that, you need to read a newspaper thoroughly. If you are not reading newspaper for civil service examination, you are committing a cardinal mistake, cardinal sin. Newspaper should become the mundane activities of your life. One of the mundane activities of your life. It is online edition or offline, or it is a, any other discussion. So you should follow what is happening around you. What is happening around you. At least you should spend 1 to 2 hours on newspaper analysis. 1 to 2 hours. 1 to 2 hours in newspaper analysis. Otherwise, it is very difficult. See why I'm saying that this newspaper, if you are reading newspaper, you will do better in prelims. You will do better in mains. You will write very good analysis, answer with very good analysis and very good content. And third, of course, it will become more comfortable for you to express your stand in interview. So they can easily sense your personality. Even though by reading newspaper, you will use knowledge, but analyzing the newspaper, you will convey the interview board your stand, your clarity of thinking, your leadership skills. Right. So the first thing that a civil service aspirant should do is newspaper. You should spend at least 1 to 2 hours in reading newspaper. Otherwise, it is very difficult to clear the UPSC civil service examination. Very, very difficult. So the whether it is Hindu newspaper or whatever, Hindu or Indian Express. So you stick to any newspaper and read at least 1 to 2 hours and some, and the first thing and you should read newspaper in integration with the integrated preparation with the UPSC syllabus. UPSC syllabus. So first, all aspirants, before jumping into the UPSC civil service preparation, take the syllabus book and buy out the syllabus. Yes, it sounds like silly, but you should do this. Buy out the UPSC syllabus, GS1, GS2, GS3, GS4, completely buy out. Now come to, okay, you know we have proper understanding, a comprehensive understanding about the syllabus. Now when you read the newspaper, you can easily, yes, this article is relevant in GS1, so I'll make a note of it. This article is relevant in GS2, Representative Acts 1951, or Parliamentary Provisions in Constitutional, Parliamentary Provisions, or Constitution of India. If you read some good example, good anecdote, yes, this particular example I can use in ethics paper, and come to economy, yes, you can, if you have that economy syllabus with you in your mind, you can easily identify which is required and which is not required for in the newspaper, which is required and which is not required in the newspaper. So you can easily make a note of it and revise whenever you get a time. Note, you can make it offline, whether in a PDF or any Word document, make a note of it and have add the content to this note. And whenever you find time, just okay, whenever when you go out or whenever you're traveling, just glance through it. This is how the preparation should be, not about sitting 10 hours or 12 hours and reading the same content. This work is not going to, this strategy is not going to help the people. You need a flexible, integrated preparation. Very flexible. You should be able to read, you should be able to prepare for civil service examination even if you are in Andaman Nicobar forest. That should be your flexible. You just have phone with you. Even a single phone is enough to clear this exam. Smartphone is enough to clear this exam, provided how you optimally utilize these resources with the same phone. So you maintain a document and read the newspaper. Just add whichever is relevant to the exam to the document, or whichever to the document, read again and again. Whenever you time, read. When you go to your work, when you are traveling, when you are going for a movie, if you are feeling that the movie is boring, and if you are feeling that the song, particular song in a movie is boring, open the document, just have glance glance through the document that you made it. This is how the preparation should be, right? So why I am emphasizing it, you should be able to stick to newspaper and follow thoroughly. Don't miss newspaper even a single day. See, if you are following the newspaper religiously, 40 to 50% of your preparation is over. Take my word, 40 to 50 preparation is over for mains, particularly mains. 40 to 50% of preparation is over, particularly for mains. Even if you are from other backgrounds like PSIR optional, some of you might have taken PSIR optional, anthropology or socially, even newspaper example you can use in your optional also. You can use that in optional also, right? This is how your approach should be. Okay, interview, that's why to emphasize, to develop that personality traits required for that UPSC civil service examination. I talked about this. Now come to smart work in prelims. This is the toughest stage out of all the stages, I feel particularly. Why I feel is that generally 4 to 5 lakh people appear for the exam, prelims examination, and UPSC selects only 10,000. You know it. UPSC selects only 10,000 people. So since it is objective type exam, the candidates who are preparing for other state service examinations or banks or bank examinations, any other examinations, they can also appear for this examination and they can also solve this question paper because it is about knowledge test and also objective type and also require some specific skills. So you may be at the disadvantageous stage when it comes to particularly prelims. So what I feel is that that's why I rated the prelims exam toughest exam. Prelims exam is the toughest exam. Prelims, toughest phase. That's why this smart work is required. 100% of smart work is required for prelims test. If it is interview or mains, it may not be. Some 70% is required, but 100% smart work is required. What is that 100% smart work in prelims? Student, just remember one thing. Prelims is not about choosing the right answer. It is not about the choosing the right answer. You cannot choose all the answers rightly. But what I feel is, with my experience, is that it is about arriving at the right answer. How do you arrive at the right answer? How do you arrive at a particular destination? Arriving at the right answer. Just give me two minutes. So how will you arrive at the right answer? How will you arrive at a right destination? By eliminating the wrong route. Because when you want to reach to a destination, there will be different routes shown to you. Some routes are very long. Yes, you may reach destination, but some routes are very, very long. You have to take different turns and twists, and some routes are very straight, very short and very straight routes. Further, you need not take more time and more efforts, right? So prelims also requires that short and straight path with more smart work, that also arriving at the right answer. So how this arriving at the right answer is, first thing is, you have to inculcate the habit of solving multiple choice questions. Give me 2 minutes, I'll be back. sorry for the interruption. So you have to have the habit of solving multiple questions, multiple choice questions in your phone. See, all of you have smartphone. So you join any groups, or any MCQ groups. So whenever you find time, just have the habit of solving MCQs. Whether you're like I said, whether you're in movie, like whether you're in traveling, whether you go on for a lunch break, lunch to take lunch outside. Just take the question and read the question. What is the question? And by having this habit, you will develop the skill of solving MCQs. Solving the MCQs is not only purely a knowledge. If you have that habit, even if you don't have knowledge also, you will arrive at the right answer. How can you arrive at the right answers? After solving number of questions, you will develop a skill to eliminate the wrong answer. So you will have the skill to eliminate the wrong answer. When you eliminate the wrong answer, you will obviously, when you eliminated three wrong answers, obviously the remaining is the right answer. See, even if you are the topper, UPSC prepares the papers in such a way that everyone knows only 35 to 40 questions only. Let me give the example. So when I gave my first attempt, my preparation was not that much good, but I solved a lot of MCQs. So to some extent, I developed these skills. So in that paper, I know only 35 questions. So 35 means you should be getting only 70 marks. But in that paper, my score was 142. How I got only extra 72 marks by knowing only 35 questions? I followed this strategy of arriving at the right answer. Right? How will you follow this strategy? See, first glance through the question paper and solve whatever questions you know directly. And now some questions you can solve by eliminating one option or two options. That I will discuss thoroughly when you go for examinations, actual examinations. But this habit you need to inculcate, smart work. In that smart work, first is MCQs, solving MCQs. Second strategy is arriving at the right answer. This is the strategy you need to follow. Right. So how can you arriving at the right answer? If you read lot of market, if you read lot of books available in the market, lot of content available in the market, you cannot recollect the content and you will get confusion in the examination. Or it will be difficult for you arriving at the right answer. So you will use number of paths. Even you can eliminate the path, wrong path. You will also think that this path is also right. This option is also right. That is why for that you need smart work by minimum resources, maximum marks. My strategy: minimum resources, maximum marks. Or you can take minimum books or minimum resources and maximum marks. This is the most required strategy for civil service examination. What is that minimum resources and maximum books? Civil service syllabus is framed in such a way that you feel that everything is relevant. The syllabus is ocean. You feel that everything is relevant. Every book is relevant for the examination. Every current affairs magazine is relevant. Every article is relevant for this examination. No, not at all. Even though syllabus appears like an ocean, but you can cross through this ocean by navigating through a small boat efficiently, smart way, right? So for prelims, what are the minimum books is I read only 5 to 6 books for prelims. Only 5 to 6 books I read for prelims. Which is about, what are the 5 to 6 books? And keep revising, revising, revising and solving. Keep revising and solving. Only 5 to 6 books. 5 plus 1 is my strategy. 5 plus 1. The big 5 plus 1 is my strategy for prelims, for clearing prelims. That is going to help you a lot. So don't read number of books. And if you read these 5-6 books thoroughly, your 30 to 40% mains preparation is also over. You need not read again for the mains. After prelims, you need not read it again for mains. What are the 5 to 6 books? The most emphasis that a candidate should give in prelims is environment. More focus should be given to environment. Why environment? Because 23 to 25 questions come from environment in this exam. Why this? Because it is prelims is common for both IFOS and UPSC civils. The prelims that UPSC conducts for civil service examination is also prelims for the Indian Forest Service examination. So Indian Forest Service examinations is all about, Indian Forest Service is all about conservation of forest, conservation of biodiversity, conservation of environment and ecology and decision. So that's why they test. That's why they added environment to the prelims. So most questions come from environment. So if you mastered environment syllabus, almost your 1/5 preparation is over. Almost 1/5 preparation is over. So for environment, you need to, I follow Shankar IAS environment. So you need to revise this book 2 to 3 times. And apart from this book, whatever organizations they mentioned in that Shankar IAS book, you go visit the websites of that organizations and follow what is happening. What is happening around the organizations? What are the new initiatives of the organization, right? Also, identify the species in use. Also, visit wildlife inventory. Wildlife inventory maintained by the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change of Government of India. In that, they gave 500 plus list of wildlife sanctuaries, some 105 national parks, 51 tiger reserves, some biospheres, 18 or 20 biospheres. So visit that and revise thoroughly, because 2 to 3 questions come from this list of national park, biosphere reserve, tiger reserves. So if you master that content easily, you can 6 to 8 marks easily you will get, where other average candidate do that. So you maintain the list, and do that environment. Only read Shankar IAS, revise and visit the websites, and also visit the wildlife inventory maintained by the website maintained by the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. Okay, now come to polity. Polity, read only Lakshmikanth. You read only Lakshmikanth, don't do any other. Lakshmikanth, if you read Lakshmikanth, you are also finishing 50% of GS2 preparation. GS2 preparation is over, is also over, almost over by doing Lakshmikanth. So you do only Lakshmikanth, but if you may feel that polity syllabus is simple, but it is not simple. So you read this Lakshmikanth book analytically. Why this? What will happen if president is not there? Don't read the Lakshmikanth book unilaterally. You need to have a bilateral approach for that. You are reading and the questions is also coming from the book. What if parliament is not session? What if the candidate is 25, not 25 years, but elected for the if the candidate is not 25 years for 25 years, but some other reasons he was disqualified, what will happen? Such a critical reading is required for the polity, because they are also asking the questions in such a way that, so they are not about testing the knowledge in the polity questions. They are testing your critical thinking on the constitutional issues in the polity. So you read that book like they mostly test your philosophical understanding and critical analysis of polity in Lakshmikant book. So for that you need to give more approach to preamble, fundamental rights, DPSP and FDs. These are called philosophical aspects of Indian politics. So in the philosophical part, they'll test four to five questions in the politics. So in this part, they will not test your knowledge, your understanding. So they'll ask, what is liberty? Sometimes there's a last year or before last year, they ask, what is liberty? The question is simple, liberty. The options are also framed in such a way that everything is relevant to liberty. Liberty is generally freedom. This is the meaning. So everybody knows that liberty is about freedom. But options are given in such a way that every option is in a one way or either way, it is relevant to liberty. But in that four, you should choose the best option, the best and most relevant option that explains what is liberty. So that requires critical and comprehensive study of the each and every issue in the polity. You may think that polity is very easy. It is just knowing about the Indian constitution and administration. No. They are testing your comprehensive and thorough and critical understanding of that. But it is very easy. If you read polity with that way, it is very, very easy. So because polity also, they test some 18 to 90 questions. 19 questions they ask from polity. So it is very, very easy to, they are low-hanging fruits. Polity questions are very low-hanging fruits. Provided you have the right approach, these are the low-hanging fruits. Apart from Lakshmikant, you can also, if you have time, you can also read Constitution at Work, so that you can easily understand the meaning, philosophical meaning of some of the terms mentioned in the Constitution, preamble, etc. After these philosophical part, you give more emphasis to Parliament and local bodies. More emphasis, and then give more attention. You may give more attention to other issues, but you spend more time on these philosophical aspects in parliament and local bodies and judiciary also. The most important topic. So revise them number of times. But others you should read, but most questions generally doesn't come from that topic. Those topics. This is how you have to give. Spend time on polity. Now come to after polity, very, very important subject for prelims is after environment and polity, history. History, you should give more focus on modern history. If you read the syllabus, they mention national movement in Indian freedom struggle. Particularly, they mention in the Indian history syllabus, they particularly mention the term also national movement and freedom struggle. National movement and freedom struggle. That's why the 80% questions come from freedom struggle. So modern India, I read only one book, Spectrum. read the spectrum book thoroughly. Spectrum book, only spectrum book I read. Don't read any other book that suggested to you. Number of books are available in the market, but don't do any other book. Do thoroughly spectrum, revise the spectrum thoroughly. And follow me, I'm telling this through my experience. Apart from spectrum, of course, you need to, I think you, most of you, you need by this time finished NCERTs. Whatever strategy I'm telling, the 5-6 books, only after reading NCERTs. NCERTs is the foundation for civil service preparation. So my assumption is that most of you might have done your NCERTs. So first you need to finish NCERTs and spectrum. That's it. Don't do anything, any other. Don't go for any other book that is recommended to you for another any other faculty or any other candidate. I am telling this based on my experience and the gain that I got by following this approach. For ancient and medieval, generally they ask 1-2 questions. So you just follow old NCERTs. You just follow old NCERTs +1 and +2. That's it. You can do. That's it. You can do. No need to do anything. Old NCERTs. Okay. That's it about. Now come to the fourth book is geography. So geography, do only 11th and 12th NCERTs. 11th and 12th NCERTs and Goshen Liang book. So for prelims, you see NCERT in geography there are geomorphology is very very important, but under this is not important for prelims. You need not do prelims because the questions they don't ask questions from geomorphology in prelims, but for mains they ask number of questions. You know, around 20 to 30 marks come from geomorphology. 20 to 30 marks come from geomorphology in mains. So for mains you can read even the content that they gave in the 11th class NCERT in geomorphology is also sufficient for clearing the writing good answers in mains. But prelims, most of the questions come from solar systems, latitudes and longitudes, oceanography and climatology, and 13 climatic zones. So that's why you need Goshen Liang. They gave 13 climate zones. What is equatorial zone, monsoonal climatic, Mediterranean climatic. Like they mentioned 13 climatic zones. You read that 13 climatic zones from Goshen Liang, and remaining you read four. These are the four important topics for prelims. Other content you can skip for prelims, but that content is important for mains, geomorphology. That's it. Geography, don't do any other book. 11th and 12th and apart from 11th, 12th and Goshen Liang, don't read any other content. So after geography, so we have done environment, we done history, we done polity, we done geography. What are the other things that is art and culture? So art and culture, every year they're asking some 3-4 questions. Earlier they used to ask 10-12 questions, but 3-4 questions they're asking. So these questions also you can easily solve. So art and culture, do only Nitin Singhania. Read only Nitin Singhania, that to give more focus to Buddhism and Jainism. Buddhism they ask one question, Jainism they ask one question. That's it, two questions over. And second, philosophy, Indian philosophies. Art and culture, he also mentioned the temples and paintings. That's it. Remaining thing, you can, that content is also appears in ancient history.
but you should focus more on temples, paintings, Indian philosophy, Buddhism, Jainism, dances, some folk art also. Give more focus to folk art also. Folk art also. Other content that you can also that content also appears in ancient history. So art and culture do follow only Nitin Singhania, right? Apart from that, don't do anything. That is more enough for this purpose. Now, what is the sixth subject? Means environment, quality, geography, history, art and culture, and then science and technology. Science and technology. See, science and technology is the easiest subjects to get more marks. Easiest subject to get more marks. Because UPSC trend, 8 to 10 questions come from science and technology, and these are low hanging fruits. The syllabus is very less, and the questions also asked in such a way that most of the options are. See, science and technology questions are framed in such a way that all the options are, most of the time, all the options are right. So, if you have thorough reading of the science and technology syllabus, and some 8 to 10 questions they ask, except one or two questions, most of the questions they frame in such a way that all the options are right. Option D is the right answer. Don't use your intelligence here. Just go blindly that science and technology, most of the questions are, all of the above are correct. Last year they asked, what are the various types of tasks that can be done with the artificial intelligence? One of the options they gave is writing short stories with the artificial intelligence. Creative short stories. You may think that bloody how, this is creative work that can be done only by the humans. How an artificial intelligence can write a short story? Artificial intelligence, you cannot create a creative works. No. Don't have such, because I thought like that and I selected wrong. My question was wrong, artificial intelligence. So don't use your brain when in such science and technology questions. Just go blindly for all questions except one or two questions. They may confuse, the options may not be all of the above, but most of the questions they frame, all of the above are right, in such a way that all of the above are right for science and technology. And science and technology, by putting less efforts, you will get more marks, because the syllabus is also very low, very less syllabus. One is space, one is ICT, information and communication technology, one is diseases, one is vaccines. Finish your science and technology in the prelim stage itself, you will get some 20 marks, 10 marks question and 15 marks question, totally 35 marks in mains, GS paper 3. 35 marks in GS paper 3. You see the last year paper? What is the application of nanotechnology? 10 marks. How science and technology can play a proactive role in our daily life? 10 marks. How science and technology has been useful in dealing with the COVID-19? 15 marks. So you need to have a integrated approach in reading science and technology. One is for prelims, and there is for also mains. There is also for mains. This is how your preparation should be. Anything that I left, any other subject I left for prelims? So in science and technology also, you focus more on ICT. The questions are ICT, nanotechnology, medicines, health diseases and medicines. Health diseases, recent diseases, health and diseases and medicines. And fourth is space. Defense. You need not focus, because they are not asking any questions from defense in the last. We used to ask some 15 years back, they used to ask some some questions, but in this time, in this they did not in the latest years, some 4 to 5, they stopped asking questions from defense. But you need, there are sometimes they're also asking the basic sciences. Basic sciences also they're asking, the particle physics. You may go through this. Some of the questions they're also asking some particle physics, right? So this is how you need to follow science and technology. Science and technology. So if you stick to only these 5 to 6 resources and 5 to 6 and have a smart work, it will be very, very easy to get 120 marks, 120 to 140 marks. So if you score 120 and above, the crucial period between the prelims and the prelims results, you can optimally utilize that time. You need not waste your time on estimating what is the right answer, what are the wrong answer, what could be the cutoff, and when can, whether will I would be there in the list or not. There will be a lot of speculations. So you may be wasting that 20 to 30 days time, but once if your prelims is done, and by the evening that you check some of the answer that you are very getting very comfortable score, that's it. You throw the question paper and after taking 1 or 2 years, 1 or 2 days break, and jump to the mains preparation. Jump to the mains preparation. But what you need is smart strategy. Stick to the only 5 to 6 books and daily solving MCQs in your phone, because now number of Telegram groups are there. They are giving questions, and whenever you find a time, just solve 5 to 10 questions each day, and solve in such a way that first, when you read the question, you think that this question is not known to me. I'm not going to pick the right answer. Come to mains. So by the time you are jumping into mains preparation. By the time you are jumping into the mains preparation, you are already done 50 to 60% of preparation in the prelims. What is GS1? GS1 syllabus is except society and old history. All other things you have done already done in prelims. World history nowadays, they're not even asking 10 marks question also. Even if you're skipping that also, you may not be losing anything. After all, they'll ask one 10 marks question. You can skip that because that will take a lot of time, 10 to 15 days. You can skip that by skipping 10 marks question, or you may write some relevant answer with the comprehensive preparation you have done in national movement and freedom struggle. You can write some relevant answer. Even if you're skipping the 10 marks question also, that will not be a big lose to you, a big loss to you. Other thing, national movement you have done, art and culture you have already done, and the geography you have already done, except geomorphology, it will take some 1 week. They'll ask some 20 to 30 marks. And society, you need to read only NCERTs, that's it. Societies plus one and plus two NCERTs, Indian society. Apart from that, don't do anything. Don't do anything. But add examples that you read in the, connect with the examples that you read in the newspaper, society. And what, believe me, there is socio-religious reform movements in freedom struggle, starting from Raja Ram Mohan Roy. So if you read that subject, that chapter thoroughly, you can write very, very good answers. Even some 50 to 60 marks you can easily score by writing comprehensively socioeconomic reforms. Because the society also will read the same social issues that prevail in the Indian society. What are the approaches? What are the issues? Like child marriages, untouchability, women issues, all this you had studied in already socioeconomic reforms. But that is in society syllabus, is the extension of the socio-religious reform movements you study in freedom struggle. That is also 50% is over. But extra you need is that what is the approach of modern sociologists to these problems, and connect with the latest example. That's it for the GS1. Remember, after prelims, immediately you need to do is
not reading separately for mains, immediately jumping into the test series, writing more tests, some 20 to 30 tests, and get them corrected, get them checked by an efficient person, a person who knows who decoded the UPSC process. For me, earlier also I wrote mains, but last year Sarath sir gave me this personal guidance in correcting the question paper. That was very, very helpful. My GS score was, this year's score is, all scores are very good. It is equal to top 50 toppers. Since I was badly punished in optionals, my rank is 441. Otherwise, my rank would have been below 100. Because Sarath sir approach. Because he tells how to hit the bullseye in the mains answer. When he wrote mains, he got 450. It is one of the highest GS. One of the highest in GS marks. So some of the answers he used to scold me that there is no, you did not address the question properly. And there is no some creativity in our answer writing. So that is how he used to correct and provided me proper feedback. And that was very helpful for me. So I got all more than 100 or 105 this year. So immediately you start, because the knowledge that you have after writing the prelims is sufficient for writing the tests. Very, very sufficient for the writing the test series. You need not do that separate preparation, except optional, you need not do separate preparation. Okay. So except society and modern history, old history, you have done it. You've already done it. You just do is extension of the GS1 prelims preparation. So write more tests. Now come to GS2. 50% GS2 preparation is over. Lakshmikant, 50% preparation is over. 50% preparation is over in the Lakshmikant book. Now 50% IR. I'm sorry, I skipped IR in prelims. Please do international relations also. IR. So 20% questions from IR. IR, they'll ask 30 plus to 10 marks, 50 marks. So IR is also, you already read sufficient content for prelims. What you need is you recollect the facts in IR and arrange a correct answer according to the demand of the questions and rearrangement of the content you read for prelims. That's it. Only that governance issues, you take any other material, governance issues, and these also you already known to you. This is also known to you. Governance issues is also known to you already. But for writing a comprehensive and more specific answer, you may take some of the material that can be finished in a week or 10 days. That's it. GST is also over. But what I'm trying to say is that you need to rearrange. How can you rearrange this content? By writing more tests and get them corrected. Get the feedback. How to start an answer? What should be the introduction and what should be the body and what should be the conclusion? This is how. Now come to GS3. GS3 also. 50% you have read in prelims. Sorry, economy I forgot. Most important in prelims. Economy. You read economy for prelims. See, I am the one of the economy faculty in Sarachandra IAS Academy for some time. Because to get confidence and to improve my communication skills, I also used to teach some of the economy classes. And unfortunately, I forgot economy in prelim strategy. I'm very, very sorry for that. So economy also, they lost 15 to 16 questions in prelims. So after finishing NCRTs, you can take any book for revising the content. You may follow Mrunal. Mrunal economy, you may follow Mrunal because he has arranged all the economic syllabus in a specific manner at one place. Mrunal, NCRTs.
both after doing that. And here also, just they focus more on banking and insurance, banking, insurance and finance sector. Most of the questions they ask. After that, they ask from fiscal policy. And then agriculture, don't skip. Agriculture, very, very important chapter for economy. And agriculture has also connection with environment and ecology. So agriculture, they'll ask 4 to 5 questions here. Totally 15 to 16 questions. After doing NCERTs, follow this. So if you are finishing this economy syllabus in prelims, 50% of, if not even 50%, 60% of your preparation is over. What you separately do is just only internal security and disaster management. Internal security and disaster management. And SERETs are guidance for internal security and disaster management is very, very, very helpful for you. Because he mastered the cyber internal security and he made some crisp notes. And if you read that notes, you can write any answer from internal security and disaster management. Believe me that. That's it. GS3 is also over. 50-60% from police preparation and rest is cyber disaster management and internal security. Some environment also you read. Science and technology also you read. What is separately you do? What is there to do separate preparation for mains? This integrated approach is required for prelims and mains to clear this exam in lesser time. So don't view prelims is a separate entity, mains is a separate entity, interview is a separate entity. No, that all have the connection. And don't think beyond that. You have that flexibility. So this exam requires minimum resources, maximum marks, how you work, what you have to identify, what UPSC is expecting. So to read the UPSC expectations, you need to do test series. The test series, you know, why I'm saying the requirement of test series? Test series develops a skill to recollect all the facts and write a relevant answers in 3 hours. Attempting all the questions in 3 hours is also a very, very difficult task in mains. And just believe me. So attempting 20 questions in examination hall and recollecting all the facts at one place is going to be, it's very, very difficult unless you do thorough practice, at least 20 to 30. And the practice should be in such a way that you're writing most relevant and specific answers according to the demand of the question. Not dumping all the facts that you know about a particular issue. First, read the question. What is the demand of the questions? And what is the keyword? What is it? Discuss, it is analyzed, or it is critically analyzed, or examine. Understand the keywords. And according to that keywords, you put your content on that. The content may be the same, but use the content according to the demand of the question. That is what hitting the bullseye. And is in that hitting the bullseye, Sarath sir is a good expert in hitting the bullseye. Right? So this guidance, his guidance was very, very helpful to me in mains answer writing. Now come to GS4. Ethics syllabus. So before going to ethics syllabus, first identify the each and every keyword mentioned in the ethics syllabus. Identify every keyword mentioned in the ethics syllabus. So what is ethics? What is values? What is morals? What is morality? What is honesty? What is integrity? What is probity? So first, before going for ethics preparation, take the syllabus book, identify the keywords and make a note. What is your understanding at this point of time of each and every, what is ethics according to you? What is values? What is your understanding of ethics? What is your understanding of values? What is your understanding of honesty? What is your understanding of probity? What is your understanding of integrity? What is your understanding of empathy? What is your understanding of emotional intelligence? Right? Right, just write. No, analyze. Just analyze yourself. Okay, this is my understanding, but this is what actually integrity. And then now go to any book, any other source for ethics. But believe me, if you are reading newspaper thoroughly, means you will also write very, very good answers in ethics. Ethics case studies. You will write very, very good answers in ethics case studies. Believe me in that. So first take the ethics syllabus and write what are the keywords and write what is your understanding of the keywords, and then read any book. Lexicon book or D.K. Balaji book. Lexicon is also a good source for ethics. Lexicon and D.K. Balaji sir book is also helpful for you ethics. And before jumping into that, what you need to do is you need to have understanding of these ethics keywords. Otherwise, it will be difficult for you to understand ethics. After doing that ethics, you need not do a separate preparation. Just with these two books, make a very, very crisp and short notes of 30 pages. And believe me, this year I did not even prepare for that ethics also. I just went and I got 106. For ethics, I need not prepare anything for this year. I wrote only 4 tests before going to the exam, 4 mock tests. That's it. I never prepared this year for ethics test. Because I know the syllabus, I have the understanding, I know the example, I have some real examples, real-time examples, I have my own anecdotes, use it that way. You got good marks. Because I already made some 30 pages short notes. And with that 30 pages short notes, I revised number of times, earlier attempts, previous attempt, that's it. This year I did not prepare for ethics. Because what my approach was that I wrote all the keywords and first I wrote what is my understanding, and I got some content from these books and corrected my understanding and made the 20 to 30 pages short notes. That's it. Ethics is the easiest subject in GS4. If provided you have the thorough and right mindset. Should have a right mindset for ethics. That is going to helpful for you. But essay themes are also very common themes are there in UPSC, like education, health. These are the common issues. So before going to exam, you need to practice at least 15 essays. Otherwise, it is very difficult to score more marks in essay. Okay, and essay is also very easiest to score more marks. Essay subject is also very easy subject. Essay paper is also very easy sub paper to get more score. And you need not put more efforts on that. What you do is at least write 10 to 15 tests before going the exam. And even need not to get feedback also. First of all, your own understanding, your own feedback, you see, after writing the essay, you just self-correct it. You will understand whether you address the demand of the essay or not, whether your analysis and flow is good or not. You can check the essay yourself. Your own intelligence is best guide for you when it comes to essay. You write the essay, read it again. Then you will come to know that what is the question is asking, what I am writing it, what is the flow, whether what's some of the dimensions that I wrote in the essay is whether they are relevant to the topic they asked or not. But you need to address diverse issues, political, economical, right, social. These you need to touch diverse issues in that essay, right? So any other doubts you have, like interview already spoke, interview from the day you are decided to do civil service preparation, you need to have this approach that you should have an open mind. It should have a bilateral relations with the newspaper articles, the issues, whether it is national issue or international issue or state issue. That bilateral understanding should be there, not getting the content unilaterally. Bidirectional communication should be there. Okay, this article you are reading. How can you question that article? Why it should not be like that? Why it should be like this? And you should have an opinion on that. let's take the recent issue, Pegasus issue. There are some issue. There are some apprehensions that Government of India uses this Pegasus software to have a surveillance on some opposition leaders and some journalists. And you have to understand what is this Pegasus. Why? Whether government did really do that or it's a really allegation. And if government is doing, why government is doing that? What is the need of using a software to have a surveillance over journalists and political leaders? Is it right to do? Why government should use Pegasus, and why government should not use Pegasus? That analytical and critical thinking is required for interview. So that because during my interview preparation, sometimes me and Sarath sir used to sit together and have this overall critical analysis of issues. That's why my score, you see, last year my score was only 160, but this year there was a sudden jump in my score, 193. So 33 marks, getting 33 marks is not an easy task in prelims. 33 more marks in, sorry, interview. 33 more marks in interview is not an easy task. 193. Why? Because last year I was answering. I was just answering. I did not have this critical and analytical thinking over the issues. But this year I was very energetic. Like I used to give more dimensions. Until the board member stops, okay, stops. I was keep on talking, and most of the questions are from my tribal issues. Last year also they asked questions from tribal issues, because I was answering. Just he was asking the question and I was just answering. But this year I was having a conversation with the board members, even though until I spoke to board members, until they asked me to stop. This approach should be there. That means they were impressed with it. You know, generally they don't say, but three board members said good. In that board, in the examination or the interview hall itself, I sensed that my interview went well. How? Because I had a analytical and critical issue over the tribal issues, or all the recent national issue or state issues, or my hobbies, Ramayana or Mahabharata. See, Ramayana and Mahabharata, everybody know about what is Ramayana and what is Mahabharata. But I had the critical thinking of this. Why Rama did in this situation? Why Sita did? Why Rama left Sita? Why Rama asked Sita to prove her chastity immediately after war with Ravana? Whether Rama's stand is right? But why Yudhishthira lost his control over over his mind during the gambling? Such having critical thinking, you should. Why they did like that? Is it relevant now? Ramayana and Mahabharata, do you think Ramayana and Mahabharata relevant today? So it's such a critical thinking is required. Such a analytical approach is required for interview. Same with the current affairs also. When you read the current affairs, what India stand on Afghanistan is, India should approach or why India shouldn't approach? Why India should approach? Why India should not approach? The content is same. Everybody knows what is happening in Afghanistan, what is happening in India, what is happening in UN Security Council, what is happening in WTO. Everybody knows that. But you should have this opinion and open mind, open approach to these issues. Then only you can do very, very well in interview. So you have any doubts, you can ask me. I think I spoke this smart strategy. I will come... In future also, I'll take more sessions like this. But believe you are at the right place, because Sarath sir almost decoded entire process of the civil service examination, especially mains and interview. GS answer writing, he almost had the thorough understanding of what is UPSC is looking for. You can ask any questions. Otherwise, that's it for today. Right? వాళ్ళు క్వశ్చన్స్ అడుగుతారా?
లేదా
మాట్లాడలేదు?
So friends, anybody has a question? You know, they don't ask. We have to see the chat. Let's see the chat one second. The last of the questions to the chat. Friends, okay. As how much time? Let me see. We have just finished the discussion. Okay. Friends, so Tirupati Rao, Mr. Tirupati Rao would be answering the questions from now on. Let me see the questions. Shobhit Suryapalli, you deserve the highest rank, sir. Thank you for that. Okay, from right. See, you can take the questions from here. What should be read for agriculture? Starts from here.
Agriculture, I recommended Shankara, yes, right? They have some 40 pages content in agriculture in the same book. That is sufficient for you for agriculture. Shankara, yes, is sufficient for agriculture.
Right strategy for main question, the answer.
Right strategy is that immediately after prelims, you need to start the mains answer writing. I told you that Sharath sir is an expert in that number of times. I do not have any hesitation to say that because I scored some 400 plus this year just because of Sharath sir. I took test series at Sharath Chandra IAS Academy immediately after prelims in October 4th. Last year, I joined the test series 11th. And even though Sharath sir is busy, thanks Sharath sir for spending a lot of time in correcting the answers and getting the right approach for it. Because he used to scold me, sometimes he used to scold me like the question is, they asked one demand and you're writing something. He criticized me also that you are not using some creativity in your answers. So there is no strategy, right strategy. You already know the content, but what you do is take a test series and getting them corrected. That's it.
What are the factors you consider for choosing optional subjects?
Optional subject that there are many factors you should take into consider: the material availability, the guidance, and your time. Because I was working, that's why I took Telugu literature. I studied up to 12th class in Telugu medium. So I thought it would be easier for me to read the Telugu syllabus. I also have the habit of writing Telugu short stories. It is one of my hobbies. Based on these factors, I took syllabus because I did not take separate coaching for Telugu literature because I do not have time. I was working and preparing for this. So you take current affairs, I told
you. Read the question and then answer.
How many years current affairs should we have prepared? 2 years. Generally 2 years. Generally they ask 2 years. But generally, even if you have the mastery over the last 1 year current affairs also, it is very, very good. Generally they test. But don't skip the newspaper. If you are skipping a newspaper, you are committing a cardinal sin. I can say with 200% confidence. What should we do if not able to CSAT otherwise? What should we do if you not able to qualify CSAT otherwise within GS? Practice more CSAT, that's it. Possibility. Do take more CSAT. That's why I told you. Stick to the dynamic portion they did not ask last year. Last year question paper completely in static. But understanding of the basics is required. If your basics are very strong, if you are asking the dynamic questions also, you can arrive at the right answer. I told you, arriving at the right answer, not picking up the right answer. Your basics are clear, UPSC, you can interview UPSC, you can conduct a test for UPSC, believe me in that. What will be the strategy for answer writing without complete the syllabus? Whatever you know, just understand the question, first try to write an answer. And you will understand. So these points should be added, this content should be added. So I need to develop the content clarity. That's it. SWOT analysis, yes, that will be good. You can have a thorough understanding of your strength and weaknesses, and accordingly you can plan for your answer writing. If I'm not making it done, reading newspaper plus current affairs, what should I do? Yeah, you can do. If you are not able to do, you can follow a current affairs magazine. But see, it will be difficult for you to write a get a proper understanding of the current issues.
With the name of personal life.
You see, Ms. Srija Namasmarma. Sir, can we read only daily current affairs material instead of newspaper? No, you should read newspaper. My approach, you should read newspaper. What prevents you from reading newspaper? I don't understand you people asking so many questions. Why? You should read newspaper, and after reading newspaper, you can go for current affairs magazines.
In the name of
Nagaraj, sir, only online current affairs materials of coaching center enough for newspaper. Again, I'm telling newspaper. No more questions on current affairs. You should read newspaper. That's it. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Friends, we'll bring Tripathi Rao once again after a few days. Maybe we'll make him teach few classes for you, either economics or history, some subject, some topics you select. He will deal some of the topics. Similarly, Gautami, P. Gautami, who got 317 rank in her first attempt, she'll also take a session in 2 or 3 days.